And it's red in the center and blue all around, with a ribbon of gold in between. And it's bigger than Texas and flatter than Spain, and it's the best country I've ever seen.
Lake Eyre. They say it only fills three times a century. The truth is perhaps a little more complex than that, but it's certainly true whenever something happens out there. We all flock to see it, perchance to witness for ourselves the great lake full of water and the deserts in bloom. This year it was the rivers of Western Queensland that brought most of the water, and it's important to know that because the Lake Eyre catchment basin is roughly a sixth the size of the continent, and it's often as much about these catchment areas as it is about the lake itself. Indeed, it was halfway along the Georgina Warburton system that I found 50,000 breeding pelicans and one besotted photographer, Pete Dobray.
When I'm going to pull myself away from here, I don't know yet. And that's the thing, I don't. It becomes a very emotional time for me because, for me, I may never get to see this because this is a rarity. To be amongst 50,000 pelicans and have, I regard this as a privilege and an honour as a photographer to document what these birds are doing, because I may never get that again. Do you know, this morning I spent 4 hours, and what I was documenting were the parents teaching the young ones, who can't fly yet but they can swim, how to fish. And there they were, I've got on vision, I've got the pelicans going under the water, picking up logs, little sticks, rocks, tossing them up in the air, catching them in their bill, spitting them out. It's almost as if the pelicans know, mum and dad know, this is where we're going to nest. We've got this little billabong and we're going to teach them everything here before we release them out into the yonder to fend for themselves. So here they've got school. They've got school of the air where they learn to fly and they're flapping their wings right now, can't get off. And then we go to the lake today, we're going to teach you fishing. It's extraordinary.
So what about predators on the eggs and the young'uns?
Well, you know, Monty, this is another incredible story. I could have got some of the most extraordinary vision for someone like Pete Dobray, and yet I blew it. I just put the video camera down, and what I saw through my eyes was extraordinary. This crow comes down, picks up a little baby that's about the size of my palm of my hand to peck at it, actually picked it up, which I thought would have been too heavy for the crow, but actually picked it up. Then bursting out of the pack, to the rescue, the hero, comes a young juvenile pelican. I thought, this is it. He whacks a crow for six, but then to my shock and horror, the pelican picks up the young baby pelican chick and eats it. I thought, you've got to be kidding. I said, where's the hero gone? Cannibal. And you know, that didn't happen once. That happened twice within a few minutes. Same bird, so maybe there might be something wrong with a bird, I don't know.
How do they all get here? How do they all know to get here?
Well, it's like anything. To me, I believe that God's created everything, nature included. And it's that little seed of intuition that he's given everybody. It's like, how do we know to do things? How do we know between right and wrong? The birds, how do they know to go from the coast? Like, a lot of these birds here have come from South Australia's Coorong, which is 1600 k's away from here. That Lake Eyre's only been in flood for probably 5 or 6 times in white man's history. And yet, when the big floods happen, the birds are there. And you know the extraordinary thing about these pelicans, Monty, is that from the time they come out of the egg, 3 months and they're flying. That's extraordinary, the growth rate. I was here 2.5 weeks ago and we had little chicks about this big, no black feathers, and now there are no chicks here. In 2.5 weeks, they've just grown to young juveniles, which are almost the size of their parents. You know, out of all the pelicans in the world, the Australian pelican, in my opinion, is the prettiest. It is just incredible. And the other thing about...
You've fallen in love with them, haven't you?
I love them. You know, they're like the beautiful, gentle giant of the skies.
So how much time do you spend on the road?
6 months.
6 months on the road?
My life, Monty, on the road is 6 months. It's not 6 months in one hit. For example, I might blaze a trail for 4 weeks, come back, do what I've got to do back in the city, go out for 3 weeks, come back 2 weeks, out 4 weeks. So in the course of a year, it's about 6 months I'm on the road. And you know, this is my office. And my office every day, or every new chapter, every 4 weeks is different. And yet, as a landscape photographer, you can't get sick of that. You can't.
And it's red in the center and blue all around, with a ribbon of gold in between. And it's bigger than Texas and flatter than Spain, and it's the best country I've ever seen.